Hi, and welcome to a virtual Compute 301 lecture by Abram Hindle on Android and MVC. I am currently assistant professor at the Department of Computing Science at the University of Alberta in Edmonton, Canada. This is on Model View Controller and Android. These slides were originally by Ken Wong. Anything in them I expect to use by fair use. So let's talk about MVC frameworks. So who is in control? There's two main kinds of reuse of code. One is class library reuse, where applications developers write the main body of an application and reuse library code by calling it. Framework reuse is similar, but the framework usually includes bodies of an application, like the main body of an application, and then the framework calls your code, the application developer code, and you reuse library code by calling it. So the real difference is that a framework calls you, whereas you call a class library. All right? So frameworks, you integrate into them and they call you. Libraries, you usually just call them. A framework, the reason behind it is basically separation concerns. A framework is concerned about the general application, the general structure, the skeletal, provides a bunch of extra code. And it provides these general superclasses and interfaces that allow you to customize them with your base class and implementations. So it provides a big framework that's pretty general, where everything works together, and you provide customized specializations in order to make your application work within this framework. If your app doesn't fit the framework, you're going to have a bad time. The app we're going to talk about today is called Filler Creep. It's available on my GitHub, and you can download and play with it right now. The idea of filler creep is basically you are trying to devour the entire universe before your cohort devours it. So you are playing yin and your cohort is yang, so yin and yang, and you basically eat matter, space, energy, dark energy, all that kind of stuff as you try to take over the universe. The side that wins is usually the side that's eaten more of the universe than the other by the time all of the universe is consumed. So here's an example of the universe being consumed. We can see that Yang has 459 portions of the universe eaten, and Yang has 340. This means Yang is probably going to lose because this guy's closer to 512. All right. So the filler creep game is a universe filled with stuff. You, Yin, fight Yang for the fundamental stuff that forms the universe. You can only consume what you touch. If you beat Yang, you consume more than Yang. There's four kinds of stuff you can eat and touch. It's energy, matter, dark energy. And you can download it from my GitHub right here. So github.com, Abram Hindle, filler creep for Android. So in order to use this game, we're going to use MVC. The model is going to be the universe and the game rules. The views that are part of MVC are going to be a text view and graphical view. The controller are going to be the game interaction rules and access to the model. So first off, we start off with a very generic model. It's called F-model. And F-model, our F-model has a generic parameter of V where V extends F-view. So we're going to have our own extension of F-view. Array private list v views, so we've got a list of views. When we create the model, we initialize the array. To add a view, we simply add it. To remove, we remove it. And then when the model changes, we can call notify views, and every view can be told that the model has changed. This is the interface for fview, and we can see that we simply update the model. All right, so this update is right here. So anyone who's an FView will be able to receive an update. The controller is less generic. The controller deals with the purpose of the game. So our general controller is the F controller, and it's got game over, get scores, which player number wins, get the number of players, get the map bitmap, play the round with a choice, the fundamental stuff, and get game score strings. Anyone who's a controller, you can call this on them, and they will give that information. They'll be able to respond with that information. Basically, the point here of the controller is to decouple the views and the model and save them from making changes to the model. So So this is the application. The point of an application in Android is basically to produce singletons and to keep state. So you can see here I got transient, private, static, filler creep. All right? I've got a static method called filler creep, and it's called get filler creep. It's a singleton, and it checks to see if filler creep exists. If it doesn't, it creates a new one, otherwise it returns what already exists. We also make a singleton game controller, and the game controller is initialized with the filler creep singleton. But notice it's an application, so it has an onCreate. The application in Android allows us to save local state in memory without communicating through intents. This can save us a lot of effort. Also means not everything needs to be serializable. We can have our singletons in here, we can forget them, but we will forget them if the application terminates. Furthermore, applications are irritating to use because you have to change the android.xml. I'll show you. So here's our filler creep application in Eclipse. It's an application, extends application. It's an Android app application. Pretty simple stuff, right? But I have to register it in Eclipse in one of these XML files, the Android manifest. Inside the Android manifest, I have to specify application. And inside of application, I give it its activities. So application is a container for multiple activities. All right. So our model is, here's our filler creep model. We've got players, we've got a stuff array, we've got fill floods, private stuff, we've got player scores. It's a little too much, but we've got get height, get players, get scores. So it gives information about the universe, can play around. Everything we need to do, we can basically interact with our models. It's a little too fat in my opinion, but it's just an example. So let's see. Here's our F model, the simple one. And then if we go to the type hierarchy and we look for F model, we can see that filler creep here is part of our F model. So we go to filler creep and we can see that we've got stuff like get stuff array, number of players, we've got constructors, here we construct the size, we've got initialize private initialization where we make a universe out of random random stuff. We've got player initialization, we've got yin player, yang player. You know, basically this model is the game. Alright. So here's an example view. How do we view this model? So here we do, here we've got a filler creep graphical view activity that extends activity but implements fview filler creep. So on create, we make a image button and we have an onClick listener on that button that when we click it will just finish up. But then we get the filler creep application and we add ourselves to the filler creep application. Then we call update map. Update map goes, gets the image button, calls the game controller from the filler creep application, gets the bitmap from the game controller, and then sets the bitmap. So the controller allows us to ask things of the model, and relatively safely. Okay, so that's an example view. So the important parts here, fview filler creep. So it implements that. It means it's going to integrate with that. Furthermore, we get the filler creep and we add the view. We add our view, which is us. On destroy, we delete our view such that we're no longer referenced. This is important because otherwise these activities can stick around. So, we've got views. We're adding views. So let's look at a view controller. So this is the filler creep text view activity. It actually allows us to play the game. So we've got multiple buttons that let us, say, play dark energy and other things. So see, it says play new dark energy. We still have to add ourselves as a view, but we've got this update. So this update means that when we're notified, we'll update. Our controller stuff is when we get the game controller and then we operate. All right, so let's go into the Eclipse text for text activity. So package explorer, text activity, All right, so here we go. On create, we call the superclass. We've got a button for text dark energy, dark matter. See, in each one we go play, dark energy, play, dark matter, play, energy, play, matter. We update the scores. We add ourselves as a view. On update, we simply update the scores. On destroy, we remove ourselves. On play, we call the game controller. This means we're actually doing something. So we call the game controller in order to separate ourselves from the model. And then we tell the game controller to play around. All right? We've also got update scores. So let's go look at what game controller actually does. Game controller decouples us just a little bit. So game controller implements F controller. Right? Game controller is our implementation of F controller. It allows us to say if the game is over, allows us to get the score, tells us which player wins, lets us get the player and gets the bitmap, lets us play around using a choice, and gets the game score strings, and can reset the game. If we go to its superclass, the F controller, we can see that yes, all of this was defined. So it's pretty simple. But the reason is that we could change what the controller does. And this game controller provides us with a layer of abstraction that allows us to save the rest of the system from model changes. So by saving the rest of the system via this generic controller, we gain quite a bit. So let's look at what the text only interface looks like. So if we go back to this text view activity, we can see that we had text matter, text energy, text dark matter, text dark energy. We can see here we've got all these options. If I click one, well, Yang played. So I can keep clicking them, and eventually I can lose. I can also view how the universe currently looks like, because this graphical view lets me see it. So if I go play the text only, I go dark matter, I can go back, and I can go see the universe, and I can see what's changed, right? I can also just have a viewer, which is the current score, and tells me what the current score is. I can also reset the game, where the current score is now 1-1, all right? I can also make a graphical interface. You see this interface, right? This is the graphical view. You see me up here, you see him down there. If I go pink for matter, I eat the matter, then I go green, dark matter, just play a game in front of you. Energy, matter, dark matter. All right, so that's how the game works.